Hey there, Mavericks! In today's video, I'm going to show you how to set up your Square Payroll account. So if you've gotten this far, you've signed up for Square Payroll and you're ready to get going. The good news is Square makes it really easy to set up your payroll. Bad news is you're going to need some documentation. So things you'll need for this video are your business's tax information, including your EIN. You're going to need your employees' information. So you'll need their addresses, social security numbers, all of your contact information, as well as their like W-4s. So I'm going to walk you through how to insert all that information into Square and walk you through the details so you can see exactly what's required to get set up and rolling with your Square payroll. All right, so you'll notice when you sign into Square that you have this welcome screen. Square makes it really easy to set up your account by giving you little prompts to follow. So you'll start by filling out this first section, which is entering your tax information. So if you click on that section, you'll be asked to insert your EIN, your federal employer identification number. If you don't know what an EIN is or how to get one or how to find the one you have, we have a great post on that at Merchant Maverick. You can search for it. So here you will enter that EIN, and then you're going to select your federal filing frequency. You're going to choose between quarterly or annual. If you're not sure, you can speak to your accountant or look at your past tax returns to see if you fill out Form 941s, which are quarterly, or Form 944s, which are annual. Once you make that selection, you will be given any sort of state tax-specific information. In this case, this business is registered in the state of California. So we'd have to enter our California Employment Department account number. This might look slightly different depending on which state you're in, but Square makes it really easy to let you know what is needed with these little descriptions underneath each box. And you also see your tax rate for your states. And so once you're done with that, you're going to click this Save Changes button at the top. For you, once you enter information, it's going to be blue. You click Save Changes. And then if you go back, once you click Save Changes, it will automatically take you back to the screen. And then you can go to your next section, which is to add your team. So currently, you'll see that we don't have any team members because we're just setting up our account. So you're going to click this blue Add Your Team Member button. You'll see that the business owner is already in the system, but you will still need to add yourself if you're the business owner to the payroll. So to do this, you can either, you know, start by adding yourself to your payroll, or you can click this blue Create New Team Member button. Both are going to take you through a really similar process. So I'm going to show you how that works. We're going to click Add to Payroll. You'll see that you'll need first name, last name, and email address. Next, you'll select employment type. So here you'll select between an employee and a contractor. Employee being someone who receives a W-2, and contractors being your independent contractors who aren't full employees yet, who you pay 1099s. Once you select, you'll notice a couple of different options will auto-populate underneath depending on which one you select. You'll also want to click here if there is an overtime exemption. If you aren't totally sure if your employees should be getting an overtime exemption or not, you can click this little blue FLSA rules, and Square Payroll kind of explains when you would want to select this or not. Next, you're going to scroll down and click your payment method. You can choose either from direct deposit or from manual check. And then you'll enter your employees' information, including their hire date. If you need to file a new hire report, if this is a new employee, you can click this button. If it's been an employee for a while and you already have your new hire report done years ago because you've had them on for years, you can ignore that part. And then next, you can select the address. You'll see the business's address auto-populating here. But if you have multiple locations or if you have employees that work remotely, you'll click this Create New and enter in the appropriate address. And then this last bit on the employee section is employee pay history. So you're going to choose whether or not you have paid this employee this year already, or if you've not paid your employee this year. If you haven't paid, that's what a default selects. You can just leave that alone. If you have already paid them wages, you can click this, and then you're going to enter the gross pay that you have already paid them for the year. And that would be your current tax year. So in this case, it would be 2023. Next, you are going to get to the compensation section. Here is where you will fill in their job titles, pay types, hourly rates, things like that. So you'll enter in the employee's job title. Next, you can select hourly or salary. If you choose hourly, you'll have to come over here and put in the hourly rate. If you click salary, you'll go in here and you'll fill out the annual salary, the full total, as well as weekly hours, and then it will automatically calculate the hourly rate based on those two data points. The next thing you're going to do is click whether or not this position can earn tips. If they can't, you'll unclick it. If they can, make sure it has that blue check. Square Payroll also has the option of calculating commissions. So if that is something that is needed for your business, you'll want to continue adding your employee as usual, but then you'll come back to setting up commission tracking. You'll click on this, and it'll take you to your Square dashboard. Once your team members are in there, you'll be able to set the commission rates as long as you are using the right Square Payroll plan. It isn't by default in all of the Square Payroll plans. The next step is you're going to add in any PTO. So if you have, right now it's everything is toggled off. So you'll need to click this on if you want to track PTO for this employee. If you're like this one, we're adding the business owner, you don't want to track PTO, you can leave it unchecked. But generally you will want to track PTO. And then you'll select how the PTO is tracked, whether it's based on the hours worked or if it's a fixed amount every year for your employees. Next, you'll add an accrual rate if you choose to base PTO on how many hours of work. You'll need to select how many hours. And then you can also input any hours they currently have logged for the year. If not, if you click fixed amount, you can just enter their balance. And then you can also, with the hours worked down here, you can set an accrual limit. So if there's a limit on how much PTO that they can gain from their hours worked, you'd put that there. You're going to follow a really similar process with sick leave. Again, choosing if it's based on hours worked or a fixed amount. The data points are going to be identical from the PTO. So just depends on what your company's policy is. And next, you're going to get to the time tracking section. This is a really cool built-in feature in Square Payroll where your employees can track their time. And when they track their time, it's going to automatically sync into Square Payroll. The way this works is through time cards. So each employee is going to get a special passcode that they are going to insert. It's basically like having another Square Payroll user without them having the admin user roles. It's just a time tracking only user. And so you'll click here, you'll generate their pay code. This is it. You'll let them know that this is their time tracking code to stamp in, stamp out. And so you'll want to make sure you keep track of that. Square Payroll will also keep track of it for you. So you can let employees know. Next, you'll notice a section for benefits and garnishments. This is another section where you're going to want to just finish filling out your employees' information first. You can't actually add any benefits from this screen. You can once your employee is in the system, but your employees have to be in the system first. So you'll want to roll around back to this, but you can add, once you get your employees in, you can add their health insurance, 401ks, whatever kind of benefits your company offers. Same with garnishments. And the next is where all of that fun information I talked about that we'll need to gather comes in. You're going to need all their personal information as well as their tax filing information. So first name, last name, middle initial, their home address, as well as their date of birth is optional. But social security number is not. You want to add that in there. And then next, you'll add in their W-4 information. So you'll need to know their filing status, as well as any additional withholding. If they're exempt from withholdings, then you would check this box. If they have multiple jobs, you would check this box. And then if they have any dependents or any deductions, you're going to enter this into the system. Again, if you're not sure how to do this, we have some great content on how to understand payroll taxes. And your accountant also is a great resource if you're not 100% sure what to put in these sections. Next, you want to, since we selected direct deposit as our pay method, here is when we would put in their direct deposit information. So you'd need to know whether it's a checking account or a savings account that you will be depositing their paycheck into, as well as their account holder name, account number, routing number. If you selected manual check, this section won't appear and you can just ignore this and go straight to save. If at any time you need to deactivate an employee, obviously that's not the case right now because we're setting up payroll, but if you did or if you needed to add team members for historical purposes who are no longer on your team, but you want all of your HR and payroll information in one spot, then you can use this deactivate button. We're going to go ahead and save. We didn't fill out all of the things, so it's not going to yet, but that makes it really easy to know if you did it right. And then next, we're going to go back to the main screen. One of the last big steps for setting up your Square Payroll account is linking to your bank account. This will be the account that you actually pay your employees from. So it's obviously really important to get it set up correctly. But Square makes it really easy to do so. You're just going to click this Add Your Business's Bank Account button. And it'll have a little disclaimer about how to connect automatically to your bank account, as well as the terms of service and privacy notices. You can click continue. And once it loads, it's going to ask to connect to your bank account using Plaid. When you click this continue button, it is going to have you sign into your bank. You're going to select which bank you work with, whichever one it is. And then you will click this continue to login button. And then you will use your bank's login credentials through Plaid. So you will click this continue to login. You'll add your bank account's login for online as you normally would, as if you were logging into your bank. And then you'll have this little button that will pop up to say connect. You'll click the connect button. It will load. And then your bank account and your Square Payroll will be automatically synced up. And that's it. That's how you set up your Square Payroll account. So you'll need to repeat as needed for as many employees as you have. But it's really a simple process. It takes a little bit of time, but it's easy to replicate and quick to work through. So as always, if you have any more questions about payroll or small business, check out our other Merchant Maverick content. Have a great one.